Doesn't matter if you need to study for an exam, learn a new language, or simply remember your anniversary. Improving your memory power is easier than it sounds. But how does it even work? How can some people retain entire encyclopedias while some of us struggle to even remember the names of people we see almost every week? In today's video, we are going to look at the science behind memory and learning. And we can train our brains to remember more and learn anything faster. Hey, before starting our today's topic, I'll request you to subscribe to our channel for awesome scientific videos. If you haven't subscribed till now, how does our brain create and recall memories? It's almost mystical, isn't it? Humans have been trying to figure out how exactly it works for at least 2000 years now. While we don't understand 100% of its mechanism, we do have a fair idea.
For example, in 2016, scientists discovered a protein in the brain that they believe play a key part in memory formation and memory loss. Brain is the basis for all human thoughts, feelings, desire, or behavior. And memory is a fundamental process of the brain, without which we would be capable of nothing more than the simple reflexes. We define memory as a behavioral change caused by an experience. For example, you remember that touching a hot iron burned your hand, so you avoid it now? Learning is defined as a process of acquiring memory. For example, learning a language. Think of the brain as a big warehouse and memories as objects stored in that space. Retrieving a memory is the same as searching for an object in physical space.
From what we understand, there are basically three stages for any memory or learning to process. One, encoding, second, storage, and third, recall. The point at which you come across a piece of information and your brain gets an input from your senses like sound, images, etc. is known as encoding.
For example, your memory of a vacation is mostly formed by your visuals and auditory system. That is how the vast blue ocean stretching beyond the horizon and the sound of crashing waves on the shore is encoded in your brain as a memory.
And when we attach a meaning or a fact to any of the sensory input, that's called semantic encoding.
For example, it's not just you randomly walking on a beach, it's you celebrating your 10th anniversary with your loved ones.
And it's no surprise that we tend to remember things better and longer when we attach meaning to them using semantic encoding. It is easier to remember your friend's birthday than any random digits that mean nothing.
All of the encoded information is then stored in different part of the brain. The nerve cell in the brain then pass signals to each other, in a sense, talking about the thing or even perceived. More to talk, stronger the memory.
We all know that there are two kinds of memories,
short-term and long-term memories, and both of them can weaken with age. Short-term memory is like a rough notepad for your brain. In it, the brain stores information temporarily before removing it or transforming it to the long-term memory. You see, you don't need to remember the food you ordered in the hotel while you were on vacation. Long-term memories are those memories that we hold on for days, months, or even years. For example, the first date with your significant other or the first time you went to jail.
So now you know how not to talk to a police officer. Finally, in the last stage, the memory is retrieved.
The brain replaces the nerve pathways that we created when the memory was formed in the first place. Repeated recalling of any memory helps strengthen those nerve connections and in turn the memory, which is why techniques like revising or tests help you retain information more efficiently. That is not to say that when you remember something, it's an exact reproduction of the original event or information, because the awareness of the present also gets mixed in with the memory.
The main reason for weakening of memory with age is the brain losing cells that facilitate connection between neurons, so that they talk less with each other. But this can be reversed. Brain is just another muscle that you can exercise. As they say, use it or lose it. So how can we improve our memory? The easiest and the best way to boost your memory is sleeping. Yes, something as simple as good night's sleep can help strengthen the memory.
It seems that sleep resets our brain, which plays a key part in memory and learning. Sleep deprivation results in the brain neurons becoming overconnected with too much activities, making it difficult for new memories to be formed. Researchers have found that the first half of the night contains the richest dose of the so-called deep sleep, and this is when the brain integrates new information, without which the memory remains foggy at best. So yeah, contrary to popular belief, you should not be pulling and an all-nighter just a day before the exam.
And hey, naps count too. And research has found that the 45 to 60 minute nap immediately after learning something new could boost your memory 500%. So relax and sleep on it. If your boss catches you napping at work, just show him this video. Another thing that helps memory takes a little more effort than sleeping. But hey, it has multiple benefits. In fact, it is one of the major pillars of health. Exercise.
Our brain function on oxygen and exercise improves the flow of oxygen. Rich blood to our brain research has found that exercise such as running triggers a protein which travels to the brain to improve neuron growth and new connection in the areas such as hippocampus, which are significant for strong memory. Exercise about 4 hours after learning a new thing is better for memory than exercising immediately after.
The exact reasons are unknown, but perhaps our mind needs time to soak in new information before you go about strengthening those brain muscles. Lastly, and trust us, we don't want to sound like your mom, but eating healthy most certainly affects your memory or even overall mental health.
Just as cholesterol can build up around your heart arteries, saturated and trans fat can build up in your brain, causing a poorer memory.
Finally, there is an old age saying that the best way to learn something is to teach it to someone else.
As you prepare to teach, you organize your knowledge and recall stuff, which improves your own understanding. You identify the knots and gaps in your own thinking while you are passing on information to someone else.
So what did we learn? Or did you already forget? Thank you for watching this video and let us know your feedback in the comment section below. And please, don't forget to share and subscribe the channel. Little more effort than the sleeping. But hey, it is multiple benefits in fact in the...
But it has multiple benefits.
There are another thing that helps. Takes a little more effort.
Takes a little more effort than sleeping.